Good evening to all of you. Thank you very much. For giving me a chance to talk to you at least two words. And I think it's a great honor and a privilege to talk to you in this distinguished gathering. I simply did not even think of giving a speech in this forum because I thought it's sort of an academic session anyway. I'd like to welcome you all to this session, to the occasion organized by SMOG, so dear President Secretary of CNA Medical Association. You didn't have any questions on CKDU, because it was a fantastic lecture given by the nephrologist in teaching us fully candid. But I know you have many questions regarding the GMO election, so what is going to happen, and then who are these people who are coming by the name of Team for Unity, and are they going to deliver the long-awaited answer the long-awaited problems in the GMO? So let me answer those questions which are in your mind. So you might wonder why we come as a separate team by the name of Team for Unity, and why we, Upul Vidanagama, is coming as a presidential candidate in the team. So we strongly think we need to bring back the glory which we had in the past with most of the senior doctors here, and when they remember the glory we had. So we'll have to bring back the glory, and we'll have to defeat this thing. We have to defeat this unauthorized centralization of power. I think you can understand what I mean by the centralization of power. The power, all the power in the GMO is centered around, could be an individual or within the hands of few people. So we have to defeat this unauthorized centralization of power. And also we have to defeat the unprofessional behavior of the current ex-co people. The behavior which we have seen recently is very unprofessional. So let us defeat that. And also we have to restore the unity, democracy, transparency, and also the apolitical framework in the GMO. Then you might wonder whether we are capable of doing all these things. Yes, we are 100% sure the team or unity, not only me, but the team we have is capable of achieving all these things. Unity has been there within the 89 years history of GMOA, which we are losing now. We all know there are two unions now. There is union GMOA, and also on the other hand there is AMS called Association of Medical Specialists. So there are a number of people who have left the GMO. So we know that we have achieved, I think the most of the senior doctors know, we have achieved so many things as doctors because we have fought together as a family. So now the family is divided. Family is ready to, I think, fight each other. So that has, just after forming the AMS, Yes, the upper thing it has been formed, I think it was formed many years back, but now it, because of this behavior of the current export and the behavior of the current leader, we are strengthening the union body. There are so many people, so many concerns, rally started, rally from the aim. So let us say, we have to stop this trend. We have to fight as a family together. We have to regain this unity which we are losing. When we talk to him, consultants actually, nationally they said, so why they have a, I think they have found few things like this, they are telling us, why. These are the reasons why we, these are the reasons behind us why we have left. So they have laid down 11 reasons. Yesterday when we met some consultants at the teaching hospital candidate, are these reasons are genuine? Truly, do you want it? Or you are leaving because you don't have the due respect and the due place and the something like that, due respect for the seniority, not only for the consultant, but for the senior, the great doctors also. Do they need a respect and a due place? Do we need to respect the senior? Then, National Hospital again, Cynthia Kuna, her retirement of the Cynthia and Dr. Sundari, her Kaipati Melua, for the union of it, then GMOA Team, and the next point, Mr. Sene. After that, He has been a president of the GMO, he has been a trustee, he has been an election committee. So he has done much, he has done a great service to the GMO, that man person. So he was verbally abused and also he was physically abused. By the way, Dr. Vijay, which actually we don't expect in a professional organization like this, like us in GMO. So we have maintained that actually. There are respect and the due place for the senior. That will be I have been in the GMA for last 18 years. I still respect my senior. Still respect my senior. So we need it to proceed as a professional organization. So we have to bring back that unity again if we want to march forward to gain any demand, any demand. Today, consultants who are leaving, tomorrow there is a great dentist, great medical assistant, might form another union, might form another union. And next day it could become administrative. So within this profession, doctors, there are maybe three, four unions tomorrow. So then when we have this separation, this split, nobody will have achievement. I told all the consultants, you leave, but you don't think that you will be able to achieve. So MS, even though they think that they can achieve, they can't do that alone. They have to be in the GMOA to achieve that. They know that they are leaving because of this unprofessional behavior of the current expo, some people. And also they have to, I talk one word about the salary, only few words about the salary, because to live with the treatment, we need to have a decent salary. This recent newsletter shows a graph, JJ's graph, which shows that you claim, you can claim 5-6 figure salary. Yes, we accept, you can claim 6 figure salary. With your basic, all allowances, if you do 120 hours extra duty, 120 hours means you have to work all 30 days. All 30 days, because of this 4-hour restriction for you. So all 30 days you work, in addition to your routine duty, then you claim 150 hours extra duty, and on top of that, you have to do a research job. So you do You work for 30 days, do a research, then you can change that. Otherwise, no. Otherwise, you have to achieve something by writing. So, after being doctor, achieving all the higher qualifications in the country, doing a great service to the nation, treating you treat the poorest to the richest, from the labor to the president of this country, you do all this job. So you go do a Nobel prestigious job, the most Nobel, most prestigious job in the country. But still, you have to keep somebody to get this six-figure salary, get this newsletter. So this is all, this six-figure salary is full of false ideas, false facts. The truth is we deserve to have much more than this. Actually, by analyzing the salary, what we for unity think is, we have to be part of the parallel rates of the state. So that is, we have to be part of the parallel rates of the state. You are for parallel? That's SLS officer, the judicial officer, the bank manager, engineers in this country. So I will tell you two examples. One, I spoke to one engineer who was parallel to me. Now he has 18 years of service in the electricity board. You believe me, I was shocked to see his basic. His basic is 175,000. Now, his basic. Whereas, after 18 years of his service in this, in the health sector, my basic is 48,000. 175,000 basic is all around, sir. His take home salary is 350,000. How many CVs in the country? There are around 1,000. We have 16,000 doctors. It's because the country needs it. But they saw it. They are going to enter. They saw it. And the number is going to come up. අපි අපි දැන් වැඩි වෙනවා. ඉලෙක්ට්‍රික් බෝඩ් එකේ ඉංග්‍රීසි 1000ක් ඇති සතම 1000යි. දැන් ආයතන 50ක්ද බෑ කවුද? ඌ ඇක්චුලි Actually, they are selling the parallel gate, they are selling this real time. More than a doctor. But T2 work, novel job, unique job, which nobody can do. Okay, this is the last thing. Now, we can say, doctors, whether one of them, Adugan, Pidigan, newsletter, computer, have a company, make company, make a gold vendor. Of it, deceived, amazing, another. Yes, sir, that is actually the eyes are dead, the evaluation is done out in job because this is not the time to talk about all these things. It's because you are tired and also you are ready to have something like refreshment and also the team. Democracy transparency is not there in the GMO at all. If you think about the sensitive issue like schooling. They have a marking scheme, which is unseen. Marking scheme is unseen. Nobody knows that. So you prepare a list and then when it goes to the office, it goes upside down.
Make this event the great victory this time. So,
Please discuss with your colleague. Send a message across. Come on 27th of this month. And vote for the equality. If you think what we are telling is true and correct, and will it change the history? I think Gampaha, our colleagues, will change. So I think they are enough. They will change the history. Thank you very much.